And we go on to the AEW Tag Team Championship. The Young Bucks versus the Real World. 21 minutes, 45 seconds. You know, I was impressed by this match for two reasons. Clearly, the finish being that FTR actually got the win. I was very surprised by that. The fact that they dared to counter the Meltzer driver. I was very surprised by that. Right. But there was also not 1,001 super kicks in this match.
Yeah, there was like 12. That's it.
I don't even know if there was that. Like, they really didn't rely on their super kicks. And the reason it's surprising to me, too, is because you have this huge event, right? UK Wembley, 81,000 plus people, right? The biggest show that they've ever had in a crowd that's never seen them before. These people are all there to watch the Young Bucks do super kicks live. And they didn't give them too many. They didn't give them too many. I was genuinely expecting this to end up like, I don't know, mostly super kicks. I thought it was going to be super kick heavy.
Their hits, if you will, they're going to play all the hits.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Exactly.
This was every Young Bucks match, I usually have a couple of the same things that run through my mind. The first one is always, I can't believe neither of these guys have ever blown out their knee. I have that thought every single Young Buck match. Because I go, these guys are like late 30s, and it's just constantly just flip, 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 back, flip, back, flip, land on my feet. Flip, flip. I'm like, what are these dudes' knees made out of? This is fucking crazy to me.
Right.
The other thought that I have during Young Bucks matches, especially when they're wrestling opponents who are exponentially better than them, is it's a reminder to me of how many other tag teams are so much fucking better.
And none of the shtick. Like, they maybe, kept it kind of clean.
Maybe they're finally starting to like get their fucking heads a little bit on straight, just a tad, to where they're realizing like we're not as big and as important as we fucking believe we are. Maybe it's getting through just a tad. I don't know. But there's no denying that FTR had exponentially better matches with the Briscoes this year.
Sure.
Way better match with matches with Bullet Club Gold.
But this was also this actually had a lot more value to it though too, Joe, because it wasn't just, hey, let's see FTR versus the AEW Buck Elite, right? The whole premise of this was, this is the CM Punk guys, and these are the Young Bucks, right? And that's what this whole thing was. This is the Kenny Omega and Young Bucks guys versus the CM Punk media scrum guys. Like, it was the division of the camps. So that's why I was expecting a lot more, I don't know, Young Buck silliness. And yeah, this match should have been as goofy and as spot fest filled as any Young Bucks match ever before.
You would have thought, yeah.
If there was ever a time for them to just be disgusting 1,000% versions of themselves, tonight should have been that night. And it's so weird because they didn't. They fucking reeled it back in. And I wonder if that was almost them throwing up a pouty face, a boo-boo face.
Oh, yeah. Like, we're not going to do all our stuff again. Like, right. It's so tough, man, because once again, like going back to the story with like Miro saying it's fake or whatever, I can't take these people's intentions to be good or pure anymore because we've seen so much passive aggressive bitchy bullshit out of them that it's really tough to just be like, well, maybe the Young Bucks realized, you know, I'm sitting there saying maybe they put together, they should really give FTR the big win, or maybe they were like, we'll just go out there. I guess if people don't like us as much, we'll just do this.
Right. See, you're thinking that they've gotten their shit straight and they're like, oh, maybe we figured it out on how to have a good match without being too extra. And I'm like, but that's what the Young Bucks are. Dude,
that's all they
you are, read the fucking book. You know that's who they are as people. These guys are extra just for the sake of being extra. So it's very weird to have this big fucking match in the middle of their biggest event. And they're like, yeah, we'll dial it back. Like, the fuck? It doesn't compute. I think that they were throwing a tantrum, if you ask me. But anyways, FTR gets the win, 21 minutes, 45 seconds. after the match, obviously FTR offered the handshakes, but the Young Bucks, they turned and left.
I don't want to shake your hand. Right. Now, tomorrow they're going to come out, or Monday, or whatever fucking day, they're going to come out as heels now, or what? None of it. They don't know what the fuck they're doing with themselves.
Follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter, at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.